What if I told you that there's a typing tool that analyzes your particular typing patterns to determine your strengths and weaknesses, and then allows you to specifically practice, if you want to, the keys that you're having the most trouble with? I recently took a deep dive into keybr.com. I have no affiliation with the site, but I like typing, teaching others to type faster, and checking out as many different typing platforms as I can. When you first start using the tool, you'll have to go through a number of different typing prompts that measure your speed and accuracy with each key. This test takes about 10 to 20 minutes depending on your typing speed, and as you can see, until the end, you're not really typing actual words. For me, this actually made it more difficult, and both my speed and accuracy were lower in this portion of using keybr.com than they were later on when I was actually typing real words. And this isn't surprising because as we develop our muscle memory, it gets really strong for commonly used words and letter combinations like ERE, ING, THY, letter combinations that are used in a lot of words. So when we start typing just random letters, it really kind of tricks our brain up. It doesn't really matter though, because the point of this part is just to measure your strengths and weaknesses and get an idea of which letters you need the most work on. As you're moving through these initial modules, you can tell which letters are being focused by looking up at the top, and you'll know that you've completed all of them when you just get to the end. There's no pop-up or sound, ding, 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 you're the winner, you finished it, which was a little disappointing, but you just get to the end, and then that is where the fun part starts. You can access your statistics. Yay, woohoo! No, but seriously, it is actually really cool because there are so many statistics and they're presented in a graphical way that makes them easy to understand, and you'll really learn about your typing habits, which letters you need the most work with. So it's really valuable and it's really cool to see. So let's check it out. So you can just go over to the right side of the screen and click on profile. And from here, it has all of the statistics about you and how you type here on keybr.com. But let's scroll down because it gets really awesome. So relative typing speed, how do you compare to other people? You can see my average at 75 words per minute right now, my top at 93. Learning progress overall. So this shows us how well we've learned each of the keys. For me, it doesn't work that well because I do know all of the keys, so it's all pretty green. You can see I've got a little bit slow here for the, looks like the H key. And I actually had that earlier today too, which really doesn't make much sense because it's in the middle of the keyboard right next to the home row. I'm just thinking that maybe I'm preparing that index finger too soon for something else and I'm not back at the home row, so maybe something I need to look at. But there are a whole bunch of these charts. So in the typing speed section, we can see how our typing speed has changed over time. So we have the lessons going across the bottom, and then our speed and accuracy are these green and red dots. So you can see, you know, as the lessons went on, my speed and accuracy went down, but hopefully that would go up over time. Then we have the key typing speed chart. So this shows for each particular key. So you can click on the different keys and it will show you. So let's look at H. See how H is lower than A. So A is like, yeah, you got that one. As you use the site more, you can go through here and you can see which keys are kind of lower on that words per minute down there. And we can also take a look at this histogram, which shows us the average speed for typing each key. So you can see this is such an easy chart to interpret. Right off the bat, I'm thinking, why is it taking me so long for H, J, and Q, and maybe T and U, but definitely like Q and J, like J? Again, that's my right pointer. What is going, I might be, you know, I'm right-handed, I have a few bad habits, I might be overcompensating with my right index finger and using it more all over the place than I should be, so it is unable to get back to its own responsibilities. So here's kind of a live example of why it's important to use the right fingers for the right key, because if you don't, your most powerful finger might be overextended and might not be able to get back to the keys that it's supposed to be able to get to. So there you go. Moving on here, we have this key frequency histogram. So this is how often we're typing these keys, but we can also see the missed hit ratio, which is the purple. So the green and red don't really matter so much on their own, but if we look down here, we want to see the missed to hit ratio. So we want this to be low. So a high number here or a high bar here means that we are missing this key a lot. So looking at J and X, looking at U2, where's H? H is, well, H is okay. It is above a lot of the other keys though. So, you know, looking at this chart, we're talking about X and J up here. J also came up. Why is J? This is, I'm discovering something just making this video about my right index finger. It is working too hard. I need to give it a break. So there you go. That's why this website is so powerful. Even advanced typists can discover certain nuances about their typing. And then down here, we can see the frequency heat map. So how often we're typing letters. This doesn't really, isn't that important, although it might, you know, help you to say, hey, I need to learn that E key really well and that N key because I'm using it a lot. And then, you know, there's just a calendar down here at the bottom. If you wanted, you can set up a practice calendar in here. But so these are the statistics that I talked about at the beginning. Absolutely awesome. I mean, already you can see I'm coming out of making this video with areas to improve upon, specific keys to work on. That is awesome. There are a few other tools here on the site. There's a multiplayer, but it's really not that riveting. I wouldn't even really give it a try. There are many other sites that you can use that are much better multiplayer. There's a typing test, which works kind of like any other typing test, so you can give it a shot. Now, there's one more thing I want to show you, and this is really important for the intermediate and advanced typists. So if we click on practice, you'll notice that this green bar at the top for me is completely green. It's basically saying I know all of these letters. There's no challenges here. But that's not true. Even though I can type pretty fast, I still want to improve. So there are a couple things that we can do to change this. First of all, we're just going to click on our settings up here at the top right. And right up here in this beginning part, the first thing we want to do is we want to set a target typing speed. So by default, I'm saying, hey, I want a target typing speed of 35 words per minute. And it's telling me, hey, you've got that with all these letters. They're all green. However, if I change this target typing speed, say to like 110, it now shows me which letters I need the most work on. So Q, J, W, H. And then there's also this other option, add letters to words. I think by default, it kind of starts like this. And if you enable this slider, you're basically just including more letters in your practice. So it might be a little more difficult, especially if it's a letter you haven't learned yet, but it will be a little bit more realistic in terms of the words that you're typing. And you're going to give the website more data about which keys you struggle with and which keys are easy for you so that they can better determine which keys you need to practice more. So once you set this however you'd like in terms of the add letters to words and target typing speed, you need to go down and you need to hit done. This is important because if you don't, it won't save your settings. You'll notice that now when we go back out, we are, you know, seeing the letters differently. We can see that some of them are red or orange, kind of telling me that I need to work on them. So right now, the current key that we're on is V. So we'll go ahead and we'll practice V. And as we go, if we're typing, say, W really well, all of a sudden, this will update even as we're typing V because there are going to be some W's in here. You can see there's one right there. And it will, you know, once we've, you know, done V for a while, it will move on to another letter and we can practice that as well. So when it comes to having a variety of ways to type and making it really fun and exciting, KeyBR might not be the best choice. But if you're just looking to buckle down and learn the keys that you struggle with the most, I don't know of a better option available. If you want to discover other fun and powerful ways to practice typing, don't forget to check out my video, Top 10 Free Typing Games. I don't just cover games in that video. I cover my favorite ways to both have fun and practice typing at the same time. So if that's something that interests you, don't forget to check out that video as well. If you found this video helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. If you want to see more typing content like this, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I'm going to leave you with me having some fun on keybr.com. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.